Yes, hello children, how are you all? I hope all of you are fine and taking care of yourself. So yes children, we are back again with a new video. Today we are going to start part 2 of lesson number 2, science, for class 4th. Okay, so yes children, as you can see that today I don't have board available because I am not at my house. So it is not possible for me to carry all the stuff wherever I go. Yeah, in the next video we have all these things available. So yes, let us start with the part 2. So all the students check out your reader, that is page number 106. Yeah, so before we start part 2, let us recollect that what we have learned in the part 1. In the part 1, we have learned about the green pigments, like how the plants will make food and what are the things which they will use to prepare food for themselves. Okay, and in the leaf also we have seen the internal structure of a leaf. You can see a leaf just like a flat surface, but inside the flat surface you have so many structures of the leaf, like how the leaves will grow, what are the different types of cells are there, what are chlorophylls, how the stomatas will work. Then again you can see the network of a leaf. You have a vein structure, you have leaf blade, you have leaf margin, you have stalk, and all those things helps a plant to prepare food. Today we will learn about photosynthesis. What does it mean, photosynthesis? What are the uses of photosynthesis? We will learn today. Yeah, so check out page number 106, science, class 4, lesson number 2, photosynthesis. Yeah, the process by which green plants manufacture sugar like glucose from water, carbon dioxide and sunlight in the presence of chlorophyll is called photosynthesis. So what is photosynthesis? Photosynthesis is nothing but the process by which the plants produces or plant manufacture what? Water, carbon dioxide and sunlight in the presence of chlorophyll. Chlorophyll is nothing but the green pigment. Okay, in the presence of chlorophyll is called photosynthesis. Means plants ke liye khane ke liye sabse teen important cheez kya hai? Water, sunlight and carbon dioxide. Okay, ye inki three important items hai jo unka khana hai. And the process by which the plant gathers this water, carbon dioxide and sunlight in the presence of chlorophyll, this process is called as what? Photosynthesis. Is that clear children? Yes, photo means sunlight and synthesis means combined. Process of photosynthesis can be written as follow: carbon dioxide plus water, which gives sunlight and chlorophyll, and which gives what? Glucose, simple sugar plus oxygen. So this process by which the plant prepares food through water, carbon dioxide and sunlight is called as what? Photosynthesis. Okay, yes, coming to the next paragraph. Photosynthesis can take place only in daylight. Chlorophyll absorbs sunlight and thus traps energy from the sun. So this photosynthesis process, it can happen in the daytime. Sirf din mein hi iska kaam ho sakta hai. Raat ke time pe plants cannot prepare food. Okay, why? Because raat ke time pe sunlight present nahi hai. There is no sun. So this process of photosynthesis can be done only in the daylight when there is sun. तो सन सिर्फ दिन में होता है, तो इसलिए फोटोसिंथेसिस का जो प्रोसेस है, जो उनका खाना खाने का, खाना प्रिपेयर करने का प्रोसेस है, वो दिन में ही चल सकता क्योंकि दिन में सनलाइट है। Air enters the leaf through stomata and reaches the space between the cell. Carbon dioxide is taken from this air. So next, air. Air कैसे जमा होता है प्लांट में? Air जो है, लीफ के अंदर छोटे-छोटे पोर्स होते हैं। There is a pores inside the leaf and that pores is called as what? Stomata. So what happens? Plants observe, leaf observes. It is leaves ke andar jo stomata hai. That stomata observes air from outside. Okay. And that air is being stored in that stomata. Okay. That air is being stored in the stomata between the space between cells. So air, khali it's not ki air mein what type of gases hai. So plants will observe only carbon dioxide. So they will observe carbon dioxide and they will store where? They will store in the stomata, in the leaves. Next, water is absorbed through the roots from the soil. It travels up the stem and enters the leaf. Next is water. So how the water, how plants drink water, how plants take water? They don't have a glass, like how we have a glass and we drink water. No, but plants observe water with the help of roots. You will pour water, तो water जो है उनके ground में, उनके roots में जमा हो जाता है, तो वही पानी उनके stem तक, from the shoot, फ्रॉम द स्टेम देन अगेन बैक टू द लीफ. वो पानी अब्जर्व होके होके वो ट्रांसफर होते हैं लीफ तक. ओके नेक्स्ट, यूनियन ऑफ कार्बन डाइऑक्साइड एंड वाटर मेक्स सिंपल शुगर कॉल्ड ग्लूकोज एंड ऑक्सीजन. ग्लूकोज इज स्टोर्ड एज फूड एंड ऑक्सीजन इज गिवन ऑफ इन टू द एटमोसफियर. सो लाइक हाउ एनिमल्स एक्सक्रीट, ओके एनिमल्स दे डू एक्सक्रीट, ह्यूमन बींग्स दे डू एक्सक्रीट, सिमिलरली दिस प्लांट्स आफ्टर ईटिंग फूड, after gathering all the important food items among themselves, so they releases what? They releases a glucose and oxygen. Okay, they inhale carbon dioxide and they release what? Oxygen. And that oxygen is been useful for the animals as well as human beings. Okay children, yes. Chlorophyll controls the reaction without taking part in it. Such substance is called catalyst. In other words, chlorophyll works here only as a catalyst. So chlorophyll, what is chlorophyll? Chlorophyll is nothing but the green pigment. तो जो जो हरे plants होते हैं, हरे leaves होते हैं, that green pigment they do not take part in it, but it's just it, it work as a catalyst. What catalyst? Catalyst works in the form of catalyst की एक जरिया है, ठीक है, पानी को leaf तक जाने का, सनलाइट को लीफ तक जाने का. सो दिस इज दैट ग्रीन पिगमेंट हेल्प्स देम. सो वो जो ग्रीन कलर के जो लीव्स होते हैं, ग्रीन कलर के जो भी होते हैं, दे डू नॉट टेक पार्ट इन इट. द ओनली थिंग इट इज द चेन, इट वर्क्स एज अ चेन लाइक स्ट्रक्चर टू ट्रांसफर सनलाइट टू द लीव, टू ट्रांसफर वाटर अगेन टू द लीव टू द प्लांट, ओके एंड टू ट्रांसफर द कार्बन डाइऑक्साइड विच इज प्रेजेंट इन द एयर टू द प्लांट. सो दिस क्लोरोफिल दे एक्ट एज अ कैटलिस्ट. Desert plants have no leaves, but their stems contain chlorophyll. So stems make and store food in cactus and other desert plants. So yes, desert plant does not have green leaves. They don't have chlorophyll, but their stem is green in color. Stem जो है उनका green color का होता है. So that stem also act as what? They act as chlorophyll. And this is how cactus plant will get all these things with the help of chlorophyll, which is present in the stem. Okay. Yes, turn your page. That is page number 107. Mushroom and molds are non-green plants. They do not have chlorophyll. They cannot make their own food. They get their food from dead and decaying plants. So yes, mushroom and molds, these are two plants which does not have any green pigment. They don't have any green substance present in them. So they cannot prepare their food. They cannot do the process of photosynthesis. They cannot take sunlight. They cannot take carbon dioxide as well as they cannot take water. So how do they get food? They get food from dead and decaying plants. So whichever the plants are dead or whichever the plants are decayed under the ground, they get food from those plants. So this photosynthesis process can be done only if a plant has green color pigment. Green color pigment, it is present in the leaf. Green color pigment is also present in the stem. So this is how the photosynthesis process can be done. If the plants does not have any green color pigment like molds and mushroom, so they cannot prepare their own food. Cactus also does not have green color pigment, but their stem contains green pigment. The stem are of green in color, so cactus can prepare their food like that. Okay, yes. So next paragraph, next bit. Nature of food prepared by the plants. The food prepared by the plants is glucose, a kind of sugar. Sugars are of many types. Cane sugar is simple sugar. Glucose is a simpler sugar. Glucose is changed into complex sugar called starch. So how the nature prepares food by the plants? Nature, how the nature is helping them to prepare the food. Like food can be prepared in the plants like glucose. If a plant contains glucose, glucose is nothing but if the plant contains sugar, plants do have sugar in them. Okay, might be their taste is different, but that taste is called as what? Sugar. So if the plant contains sugar, then it can prepare food. Example like sugar cane is there. So with the help of sugar cane, you can make what? Sugar for yourself. Okay, glucose in the simplest sugar, glucose is changed into complex sugar called starch. Again, the glucose is also a liquid type of sugar. So this glucose can also be compared and can also be changed into starch. So this is how the nature is helping the plants to make food for us. Glucose and cane sugar are very sweet, but starch is not. So glucose is very sweet. Sugar cane, have you ever seen sugar cane? Yes. That sugar cane is also very sweet. We can easily eat it. But not that much sweet. Sweet fruits contain simple sugars. Maize, rice, millets and wheat contain complex sugars called starch. So if fruits, आप कोई भी फल खाओ, कोई भी fruits खाओ, वो मुँह में क्या होते हैं ना? So that contains what? It contains simple sugar. It contains what? Simple sugar. कोई भी fruit क्यों मीठे होते हैं? They are very sweet because it contains sugar in them. It contains what? It contains sugar in them. So, but maize, rice, millets and wheat, they contains starch sugar. They do contain sugar. Just you taste. आप rice, आप millets, आप आटे के जो दाने होते हैं, ठीक है, वो दाने खा के देखो, आपको कहीं ना कहीं आपको sweetness आती है. But that is not that much sweet, but that also contains sugar, which is called as what? Starch. Most complex form of sugar is cellulose. Cellulose is the fibrous portion of any root, stem, leaf or fruit. After eating cellulose or starch, animals convert it to glucose and get energy from it. So plants, animals, they cannot cook the food. So what happens? They eat these things raw. Okay? So what happens? For that animals, they transfer it into cellulose. And this cellulose help them to convert into glucose, and that glucose gives the animals what? Energy. We cook in order to make the food tasty, but animals, they cannot cook the food. So in order to that food items which they are eating raw, that is been converted to cellulose, and that cellulose convert it into glucose, and that glucose gives energy to animals. Okay children, so this is how the nature is helping us by providing these food items to human beings as well as animals. So for this, till here this much is enough. Yes, I provide animated videos also related to this topic. So you can observe, you can watch that video and you can understand what is the process of photosynthesis. We'll be back with the next session with the next video. Till then children, goodbye and take care.